Okay, good. Thank you for the opportunity. Here I will present my research about improving the performance of the extractive transition by a novel topic modeling and sentence embedding technique using SBERT. There are at least 5.6 billion web pages that have been indexed by search engines such as Google and Bing. On the other hand, research show that the average reading speed of an adult human is about 200 to 400 words per minute. With the limited human reading ability and the massive amount of available text data, there is a need for an automatic text summarization system. The automatic summarization system can produce extract or abstract summary. The extract is a collection of are taken directly from the input text. Meanwhile, abstract are text composed of new sentences generated from computer-generated internal representation based on input text analysis. Text summarization system that produce extract summary called extractive text summarization system. There are various techniques have been developed to create extractive text summarization system, including graph-based summarization, features vector space-based summarization, and cluster-based summarization. Meanwhile, the cluster-based text summarization group similar sentences into the same cluster and avoid grouping sentences with different topic into the same cluster. Cluster-based summarization convert the input text into semantic class-based vector representation. Cluster the input text to find candidates for latent topic region in the input text, and then create summary text by taking the cluster representing each other region. One of the clustering technique used for the text summarization is density pix clustering. Density pix clustering have two main assumptions. The cluster center has a higher density than another point outside the cluster center, and the cluster center point is far from other point with higher density, which is another cluster center. Previous research by Wang et al. Implemented latent Dirichlet allocation for topic modeling, vector space model for sentence embedding, and density pick clustering for clustering. This achieve satisfying performance in the UC 2004 set. However, further improvement is still a chance. Sorry, there's a problem about the slide. Sorry, I will reconnect this. Previous research by Wang et al. Implemented latent Dirichlet allocation for topic modeling, vector space model for sentence embedding, and density pick clustering for the clustering process. This achieved satisfying performance in the DUC 2004 dataset. However, further improvement is still a chance, specifically by applying a sentence embedding technique based on artificial neural network. Finally, we found the suitable artificial neural network based sentence embedding technique for improving the baseline method. This is the SBERT. SBERT is a modification from the BERT. SBERT can do several tasks that cannot be done using BERT, including semantic comparison on a large scale, clustering, and information retrieval using semantic search. SBERT is state of the art method for sentence embedding. This research proposed a cluster-based automatic text summarization using SBERT for embedding and topic modeling, and density pick clustering for the clustering process. First, the pre-processing will be carried out for the input text document. This process will be split the input text document into sentences. Next, the sentences will be processed by SBERT to produce the sentence embedding for each sentence. We use the pre-trained expert model trained with semantic textual similarity task. The resulting sentence embedding is then used to do the topic modeling process and calculate quotient similarity between sentences, which is used to calculate the scores at the later steps. There are five scores calculated for each sentences, that is informativeness score, representativeness score, diversity score, length constraint score, and numerical data score. Density fixed clustering is done implicitly in the calculation of representativeness score and diversity score. The representativeness score ensure that the sentence it is at the center of cluster, and the diversity score ensure that the center point of one cluster is far from the center of another cluster. Meanwhile, the informativeness score, length constraint score, and numerical data score are not the part of assumption contained in density fixed clustering, but are involved with the assumption that this three score can also help choose the best sentence in the tree. The pre-processing carried out is sentence segmentation, step word removal, and lemmatization. Sentence segmentation transform a text document into a series of sentence. This process is needed because the following process, that is the sentence embedding using SBERT, accept input in form of sentence array. Step word removal is the process of removing word with low information value from sentences. Lemmatization is the process of reducing a word into its root to be grouped with another synonymous word. We modify the informativeness score equation proposed by previous research. In our method, the probability was directly derived from the topic modeling process in our proposed method. First, pre-processing is done for all sentences in the corpus. Then, sentence embedding using SBERT is carried out on all sentences in the corpus. The resulting sentence embedding need to be reduced in dimension because usually the clustering algorithm cannot group high dimensionality input. In this research, the UMAP algorithm was used to perform the dimensionality reduction process. The dimension reduced embedding is then used as an input for the clustering process, which group document with the same topic into one cluster. The clustering algorithm used is the HDB scan. After the HDB scan generate the cluster, the topic probability can be calculated simply by dividing the number of document belong to each topic by the total number of document in the whole corpus. The next process is calculating the word probability. We use class-based TF-IDF method. This technique can extract what makes each set of document unique compared to the other. The next score is the representativeness score. One of the hypotheses underlying density clustering is that the cluster center has a higher density than another point outside the cluster center. Thus, a sentence can be considered more representative if it is located within a higher density region, which is indicated by the presence of many other similar centers. The similarity value between sentences was calculated using the quotient similarity. And then the third score, the diversity score. A high diversity score in a sentence indicates that a sentence has a different meaning from another sentence. This is in line with one of the hypotheses underlying density fixed clustering, that one of the characteristics of central point of a cluster is that it is far away from another point with higher density. The length constraint score is involved as a opponent for the informativeness score. Longer sentence tend to have higher informativeness score because they contain more information. When a summary consider only the informativeness of a sentence, it tends to contain longer sentence. Therefore, the length constraint score is involved to ensure that the resulting summary doesn't contain too long sentences, but still contain information that is considered important. The last score is numerical data score. The numerical data score show how much numeric data is contained in a sentence. Generally, a sentence containing numeric data contain important information, so they are considered good if we include it in the summary. To get a summary that contain more information, higher relevance, and higher diversity with certain length threshold and contain important information in numerical form, an integrated sentence scoring method is used that combine the five constraints into one final score for each sentences. The final score for every sentence is calculated using the log linear integrated sentence scoring. The alpha, beta, gamma, delta, and epsilon parameter we use to set the weighting of each score. It is necessary to carry out a series of experiment to find the best configuration of these parameters. And after having a final score for each sentences, then the summary is generated by extracting the sentence with the best final score until the predefined length limit is reached, by treating the selection of sentence summary as a knapsack problem.
Excuse me for interrupting. You have 2 minutes left.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. The experiment were carried out with the same dataset as the dataset used in the previous study. That is the UC 2003 and the UC 2004 from the Document Understanding Conference. As in the previous study, the UC 2003 was used for training in form of parameter tuning, while the UC 2004 dataset was used for the final evaluation of the proposed system. There are 7 parameters need to be tuned through a series of experiments using the TUC 2003 dataset, that is minimum cluster size, omega, alpha, beta, gamma, and epsilon. Each parameter has a different value range and step size. When tuning one parameter, the best value for another parameter is used based on the result of previous tuning. And based on the parameter obtained from the parameter tuning process, a summary for the UC 2004 dataset is performed. And this table shows the comparison of F score value of Rogge score for the UC 2004 summary created with the proposed method and the summary created using the summarization system built using the previous baseline method. Clearly visible at the table that our proposed method outperformed the previous method in terms of Rogge score of the resulting summary. This is an example of a summary generated from the proposed method and its comparison with one of reference summary provided by the data set. The document in the cluster discuss the aftermath of Y River Accord signed by Palestine and Israel. The resulting summary of the proposed method successfully convey essential topics, which are also shown in the target summary.
Next, could you please finish the presentation now, so we can have a question and answer session.
Okay. I'm sorry. I have longer time than the limit.
Oh, it's okay.
Okay. May I stop the sharing?
Oh no, you can still present your presentation. Okay. Maybe there is a question about your presentation. Are there any question from the audience? Okay, I will ask something that I'm not really understand about density peak clustering. In that process, do we have several clusters as the result of density peak clustering? Because I thought it's the calculation, actually, the process inside the density peak clustering.
Okay. About the density peak clustering, actually, it makes several cluster as its name, clustering. Clustering, of course, make several cluster. But in this technique, the clustering process is done implicitly. So we cannot clearly visible, clearly see what document enter into what cluster, but this clustering is done implicitly by ensuring that one center point of the cluster is far away from another center point of the cluster, and one point of one cluster is has the cluster center has a higher density than another point outside the cluster center. By ensuring that two main assumption is done in the clustering process, so the clustering process is running with good threshold.
Okay, so that's implicitly we have clustering inside the density clustering. Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you very much, Mr. Paulus Setiawan, for valuable information you gave in your presentation. It clarifies my inquiry.